Welcome to ETBU Plus for this home acrobatics and tumbling meet between the East Stroudsburg Warriors and your East Texas Baptist University Tigers. Ethan Bond here with Evan Garcia with you for today's meet. Evan, good to be here with you.
So good to be here. I'm so excited. This is second meet of the season here at home for the Tigers and the third one for the Tigers.
Let's take a look at the rosters for both sides. First, for the East Stroudsburg Warriors, number one, Marissa Brady. Number two, Chloe Schaefer. Number three, Angelina Galey. And number four, Nick Drosnock. Number five, Jayla Reiner. Number six, Emily Park. Number seven, Alyssa Takis. Number eight, Allison McCullough. Number nine, Tiana Brown. Number 11, Melissa Ellis. Number 13, Callie Foreman. Number 14, Abigail Glazeski. Number 15, Kayla Reinert. Number 16, Jillian Brungard. Number 17, Christiana Brettel. Number 18, Carly Nuys. Number 19, Kayla Vandemark. Number 20, Nicole Carlo. Number 21, Kelly Fluck. Number 22, Ella Rao. Number 23, Julia Dessert. Number 24, Rachel Carr. Number 26, Kimberly Young. Number 31, Madison Eigenrock. Number 33, Kristen Stanek. Number 36, Gabriella Griffo. Number 38, Michaela Lee. Number 39, Alexandra Timpiero. Number 41, Bridget Lutz. And number 42, Jaylene DeJesus. Head coach is Christina Cricket Gulix. And for your ETBU Tigers, the roster, number one, Maddie Lozano. Number two, Zoe Connor. Number three, Brianna Brown. Number four, Emma Levy. Number five, Jessica Coleman. Number six, Emma Ryan. Number seven, Sydney Job. Number nine, Kaylin Williams. Number 10, Ellie Davis. Number 12, Emily Blaylock. Number 13, Killy Davis. Number 14, Jaden Stroman. Number 15, Hannah Donnelly. Number 19, Macy Goff. Number 21, Naomi Mays. Number 22, Katie Melton. Number 23, Jordan Reeves. Number 24, Meredith Griffin. Number 26, Sasha Wigand. And number 31, Mallory Golden. Head coach is Berkeley McDonald in her first season, assisted by Haley Stroll.
Okay, so just what you just saw was the first event up here from East Stroudsburg University. It was compulsory acro heat.
Ten possible points for the compulsory acro, 40 possible points total for the entire compulsory event. So for those of you who don't know, the way that things work in acrobatics and tumbling is there are the compulsory events that are put out at the beginning of the year. Every team has to do what is the compulsory for the year. And so it's kind of an even measure of scoring in that way. And then after that, other events such as toss, tumbling, things like that, it is up to the team and the competitors as to what skills they want to do.
Yes, the team competition is consisted of six events. We have compulsory event, which is what we're in right now, followed by three heats within the acro event, followed by pyramid event, and then halftime. Then after halftime, we will go straight into the toss event, the tumbling event, and the team event. The running score will be kept throughout the meet, and the team with the most points at the end of all six events is the winner of the meet.
The Warriors getting going with their compulsory acro as that is being scored right now. Looked pretty clean overall from the Warriors. Nothing majorly stand out as a negative.
Yes. So I'm going to give you a little background of compulsory. Compulsory consists of four heats, acro, pyramid, toss, and tumbling. The skills for compulsory event represent the basic skills of the sport of acrobatics and tumbling. In this event, each team will execute the same skills for direct comparison. The officials will be looking for strong body positions, 3-second holds, stability of structures, skills, and strong catches.
As ETBU now moves on to the compulsory acro.
Thank you. Okay, so what we just saw was that ETBU Tiger started off with a toe pitch tuck, and it looked very clean to start off. They went into a Tarzan, into an inversion.
So like you said earlier, the judges looking for synchronization, strong body position, things like that. We did see a little bit of a synchronization issue early,
yes.
And then obviously there was that, you know, little bit of a fall there on the left side of your screen. So going to get docked some points for that. But overall, if you take that out, a pretty clean looking compulsory acro for ETBU.
Yes, for sure. I know compulsory is not one of their ones they're looking for the most points for sure, but I know later on into the meet they'll be getting a lot more points to make up for that.
And we are going to get the red flag for that fall. So that red flag basically means because there was a major issue with what went on, there is going to be a significant deduction. It's slipping my mind what exactly the major deduction is per event. Because it was the compulsory acro, I know that it's at least, it's a 1 or 2 point full deduction. It's slipping my mind as to what it is. So seeing that red flag, not a great sign for ETBU to start, but with that fall, kind of one of the expected ones there.
Yes, I believe it's a 2 point takeoff right there.
So with all of that going on, ETBU looking to find something in the sevens here to try to stay tight on this compulsory acro, especially with how clean it was from East Stroudsburg.
Yes, for sure. Now, each team is going to come in with different levels that they are trying to hit. Based on the difficulty of the skill you're doing, the higher you are able to place. So I'm not sure which team has a higher difficulty right now.
Now we're going to move to the compulsory pyramid. Again, just like the compulsory acro, 10 possible points. It's a 2-2-1 inverted pyramid. All feet start on the floor. Mid-level bases are in shoulder sits. Top is tossed from below the shoulders to an inverted 2.5 high position. The dismount is a 180 pop release with a 180 twist to two catchers as East Stroudsburg gets going.
That was a very clean pyramid from the Warriors right there.
Yeah, it's hard to, you know, obviously the judges have a better view than we do. Obviously they're a lot more trained than we are. I know you have a lot more knowledge in the sport than I do. So for the most part, a very clean looking overall, maybe the tiniest little bit out of sync, but the body positions looked good. Everything, at least from my view, looked very, very good.
Yes, there's definitely some synchronized issues right there, but very minimal. It was a very good pyramid by the Warriors. And I'm excited to see what the Tigers have up for us next with this next pyramid.
Now, the other thing you mentioned earlier, ETBU isn't a team that really looks for the compulsory event to find a lot of their points, and of the events to not be necessarily looking for a lot of your points from, the compulsory is one of the better ones, as it's only worth 40 possible points. Obviously, the acro is worth 30, the pyramid is worth 30, and the toss worth 30. ETBU much stronger in those, the tumbling worth a full 60, and then ETBU really looks to excel in that team event, which is worth 110 possible points.
Yes, I know they've been working super hard on that team event to try to get as many points possible right there.
As ETBU comes out for their compulsory pyramid. very clean as well from ETBU. You can see the excitement on their faces, feeling like they did very well in that one, and I'd have to agree.
Yes, that was a very clean pyramid that they just performed right there. So I'd like to shout out the flyers of Jessica Coleman and Jaden Stroman, that very strong straddles right there.
Strong straddles. You saw those middles from ETBU really having to push in that one, and it seemed like for a second there may have been a little bit of, what's the word I'm looking for, instability there, but really fighting through and getting that lock on top to keep those flyers up there and keep everything solid.
I think that was Ellie Davis, who I know exactly what you're talking about, had a great save right there.
Ellie Davis and Kaylin Williams both as those middles, doing a great job. The catch looked clean. The synchronization coming down off top position looked great. So ETBU with a pyramid to be very happy with. Now we will move on to the compulsory toss. It will be two groups performing a synchronized basket toss, two synchronized backtuck crosses, four bases tossing, one flyer in each group. And everything looking very good on that.
Yes, very clean tucks right there.
Two little minor issues that may come up in the judges' scoring. It looks like the flyer there on the left side of your screen maybe have gotten a little bit more height, and it messed up when coming down. And then the flyer there on the right side came down with her body position a little bit too caved in, if you will. Her feet and her top were a bit, her feet and her head were a bit high up in the air.
Yes, I will say the tucks did look very clean. I did see a few of the things that you were talking about. However, I'm not too sure with the synchronize and the tucks. That's very hard to synchronize. It'll be very minimal points deducted for those. So for this Monday night, East Stroudsburg is coming all the way from Pennsylvania. A lot of their athletes are from all over New Jersey, Pennsylvania, New York, very, very far from out here. Most of our athletes range from Texas to Louisiana, and we have one Oklahoma. Oh, I take that back. Jessica Coleman is from Michigan.
Yeah, acrobatics and tumbling being such a new sport, it really, because it brings in those elements of competitive cheer and dance and gymnastics, it seems like the athlete pool that a lot of schools are getting is really a lot more wide-ranging than you see in a lot of other sports at this level.
Yes, especially at ETBU, I feel like we have a lot of students and athletes from Texas. A very clean toss from the Tigers as well.
Yeah, everything looking great there. ETBU, it seems like as this program goes on through the years, just seems to get better and better.
Yes, and with a new coach, Berkeley, taking over this year, I'm super excited to see what she's doing. She brings in a younger face and a lot more and some experience, as she was on the acro team, I believe, just last year, maybe 2 years ago. But I know she has made a strong connection with all the athletes, and we're so excited to see what she's going to do with this program. Now we'll go into the final heat of the compulsory event and we'll go into the tumbling heat right here.
Like you said, moving into the tumbling heat. So what they are looking for here is the skills in this order: a standing back tuck to front, a toe touch tuck to front, a handspring tuck to front, and then a round off handspring layout from left to right in two lines. A little bit of a stumble there as we saw.
Very clean tuck right there.
Great looking so far.
So right there, we had no falls at all from the Warriors. However, there was a little bit of synchronized mix-up right there, but it doesn't look like it'll be taking off too many points from the Warriors.
Like you said, a little bit of synchronization issues at times. We did see a couple little stumbles, but no falls. The biggest issue that I think the judges may take off for is in that final tumbling pass, a bit of an issue when it came to trying to stay in those designated two lines. Things got fairly jumbled pretty quickly.
Yes, for sure. As a previous gymnast, I know it's very hard to stay in your lane, but once you learn, you got to stay so you do not hit any other athletes or harm any other athletes. So next we'll have the Tigers coming up in the final event of the compulsory event, and they'll be showing off their tumbling heat.
Now ETBU with their compulsory tumbling here. And a good compulsory tumbling heat from ETBU. Obviously, the biggest issue there being is it's supposed to be performed by 8 athletes. ETBU, a team that doesn't have as many when it comes in the way of tumblers. And so making the decision to, they know they're going to take a deduction either way, and deciding they can likely get less of a deduction only having 5 athletes do the tumbling, rather than to have athletes out there that maybe not be quite as good, have to deal with some falls or things like that.
Yes, I have to agree. With acro and tumbling being such a new sport, it has been very hard for, I believe, teams all over to get athletes to come on. It's very hard with gymnastics and athletics as well. However, I think that was a great performance by the ETBU Tigers. There was no falls, a little synchronization issues, but other than that, I didn't see anything wrong.
Yeah, they were able to keep in those defined lines on that last tumbling pass. Saw fewer stumbles from ETBU than I saw from East Stroudsburg.
Yeah, they put out, I believe, their five strongest athletes. I know they have a few athletes out right now, but when those athletes do come back, I know this team is going to be great.
And it's one of those things that kind of shows, even in Berkeley McDonald being a first-year head coach, kind of making that business decision to decide, hey, I would rather put our best five out there for this meet rather than trying to go to eight athletes that may cause extra issues.
Yes, I have to agree. Berkeley made a really good decision there, and I'm hopeful that it'll work out right here. It has been very it has been working well recently for the Tigers, as they just had a win their first home meet and then suffered their first loss of the season, that I think 2 weeks ago, to the UMHB Crusaders.
Yeah, ETBU currently 1-1 on the year. Took a win over Texas Lutheran University, 219.845 to 179.830 on February 10th. And then back on February 18th, a 209.895 to 267.795 loss to UMHB. UMHB, a team that obviously ETBU has a lot of experience with, not just in this sport, but in a lot of others. UMHB, one of the better programs in this region.
Yeah, very strong acro and tumbling team they have over there.
Well, fun fact for you, this is actually the first time that ETBU and East Stroudsburg have faced off in acrobatics and tumbling. So as scores come out, let's take a look at them. First off, for the compulsory acro, East Stroudsburg taking an 8.700, ETBU with a 7.100, likely due to that fall in the compulsory pyramid. East Stroudsburg taking a 9.650, ETBU with a 9.550. In the compulsory toss, East Stroudsburg taking a 9.700, ETBU with a 9.550. In the tumbling heat, East Stroudsburg with an 8.300, ETBU with a 6.250. Giving us total scores for the compulsory event, East Stroudsburg in the lead with a 36.350 to ETBU's 32.450. These two, all of the individual events with a start value of 10, making a total of 40. So East Stroudsburg with almost a 4-point lead as we go into the acro heat.
The first heat we have up here is the fifth element performed by East Stroudsburg University. Their start value is a 9.85.
East Stroudsburg, like you said, with that high difficulty start value, 9.85, looking very clean overall.
A Okay, to give you some insight on this next event in the Acro event, this marks up the beginning of the optional portion of the meet. Each team will compete with skills previously chosen from with different possible start values, as we just saw in East Stroudsburg. There will be between two or four athletes on the floor in each of the three heats and as many as eight in the synchronized heat. Heat one has five elements, which we just saw. Heat two will have six and is synchronized. Heat three has seven elements. The start value is determined by the difficulty and combination of each skill. Each position must hold for 3 seconds. The officials will be looking for body position of the top, stability from the base, and continuability of skills. This event demonstrates power, strength, and balance from these athletes. ETBU is now performing their first five element with a start value of 9.00. Good event there by ETBU, a good inversion, a little stability issues up there at the top, which you must hold for 3 seconds. I don't believe she held it completely for 3 seconds, but it was pretty close.
Yeah, it didn't look like she got the full three on that last skill there. That's obviously going to be a deduction.
And ETBU is starting off with a lower start value for this event.
It's another one of those business decisions that goes into acrobatics and tumbling. Obviously, when you get to set your own start values, it's kind of that balance between, you know, do we want to go big and try something difficult and risk it, or do we want to do what we know that we can do? And personally, I believe it tends to be the smarter decision to do what you think you have a really good chance of getting close to that start value, rather than trying to take a risk of a bigger issue with more difficult skills.
Yes, it's definitely a gamble out here, but just trying to hit the best skills that the Tigers have and the Warriors have. I mean, show off as many skills and big skills as you have. Now, I'm not sure if it was said before, but each heat of the next three heats, the 5, 6, and 7 element, are possible of 10 points each. Now, each team is, like we said before, able to have their own start value.
Well, the judges do scoring. Next up will be the sixth element in the Acro event. This one a bit unique when it comes to the Acro event, as you do have to have two groups performing in sync. So a little added difficulty there.
And East Stroudsburg is starting off strong with a start value of 10.00. So going for all the points right here. Now the Warriors with a very strong sixth element right there, a very good inversion hold right there at the end. by their flyers.
Yeah, very little on that when it comes to things to pick on. It seems like they made a good decision in going big and going for that start value of 10 here in the sixth element. Obviously something that the Warriors excel at.
Yes, definitely. It's always something to gamble with, but whenever it works out, you can't be any happier. Now, next up will be the ETBU Tigers, and their start value is at 8.40. Now, like we said before, ETBU Tigers, this is a very new program, so we will see their scores a little bit lower than the Warriors, who are a more established team down there in Pennsylvania.
The Warriors currently 1-2 on the year when it comes to their record. First off, they started the season with a loss to Cootstown, 235.160 to 250.430. They then followed it up with a meet against number 4 Gannon, in which they lost 235.160 to 276.235, and then a win against Georgian Court, 224.85 to 173.37. ETBU obviously with the lower start value there. A couple of minor issues with synchronization. A little stumble coming down from top position there.
But they definitely picked it up with the aversion. Great bases right there with Kaylin Williams and Ellie Davis again. I believe it was Katie Melton and Meredith Griffin who were also the bases as well. And we had a great inversion hold by number four, Emma Levy, and number 23, Jordan Reeves. Heat number 3 of this event will be an 7 element, and up first with a start value of 9.95 is East Stroudsburg University. Now, they're aiming high again, only 0.05 points away from 10. This seems to be one of their stronger events.
It does seem like they're a strong acro team. We saw in the compulsory acro a bit of an issue as we early from them, but obviously correcting it here in this acro event. Very strong 5-element and 6-element for them so far.
Another strong and clean performance by the Warriors right there.
Yeah, great work there. Nick Drosnock, the flyer, doing what she has done throughout this meet so far, just being clean up top. Obviously, some very strong bases for East Stroudsburg.
Yes, their team just seems to be clicking together and working together really well. And I believe we talked about Coach Berkeley, but also the coach for the Warriors. This is only her second season here, which is just amazing to see how great her team is doing. Now next we'll be going into the seven element from the ETBU Tigers, and their start value will be a 9.20. Now, as we're waiting for the Tigers, let's do a little bit more about this acro event. Each sequence counts a maximum of 45 seconds. Athletes must compete a required number of skills in each heat, which, as we can see, is 6, 7, and 5. Timing begins with the first movement. Exceeding the 45 seconds will result in a time deduction. In each heat, teams must attempt all required number of elements in addition to their required skill. Now here are the ETBU Tigers.
Good work by ETBU there. They're obviously happy with their performance.
Yes, a good performance. It started off with Macy Goff with a tuck, and then this just shows how versatile these athletes are. Macy Goff started off as a flyer and ended up as a base for the last inversion of the sequence. And that completes our acro event.
We are waiting on scores to come in for the seven element for ETBU.
Now, while we're waiting for these results of the event and where our meet is standing, let's introduce the next event that we're going to be doing is the pyramid event. It's our final event in the first half. In the pyramid event, athletes will build three layers in a structure. The start value of each heat is determined by the difficulty and combination of the entry, structure, and dismount. The pyramid event has three different heats with different requirements for each heat. Heat 1 must have an inversion, heat 2 must have synchronized, and heat 3 is an open heat. Key things the officials will be looking for are a hold by the top for 3 seconds following the entry, stability of the structure, and a smooth dismount that ends with either a catch or a landing.
with that, let's get the scores for the acro event. First, for the five element, East Stroudsburg with a start value of 9.85, their score a 9.300. For ETBU, a start value of 9.00, ending up with an 8.050, which they are obviously very pleased with. In the sixth element, East Stroudsburg with a starting value of 10, getting a 9.250. For ETBU, a start value of 8.40, ending up with a 7.30. In the seven element, East Stroudsburg with a 9.95, ending up with a 9.500. ETBU with a start value of 9.20, ending up with a 7.900. For the Acro Heat in total, the Warriors with a 28.050, ETBU with a 23.250. The running total for the meet so far, East Stroudsburg with a 64.400, ETBU with 55.700. So East Stroudsburg has opened up an 8.3-point lead after two events.
Now the Tigers definitely have some making up to do right here, but here we're going to go into the first pyramid, the inversion pyramid, with the start value of 9.80 from East Stroudsburg University.
And East Stroudsburg obviously thrilled with their performance there.
Yeah, that was a great pyramid right there. I always have to give kudos to the base right there, who was holding a bridge the whole time with not just one, not two, but three people on top of her holding them. And if you're unfamiliar with an inversion, is when they're on top of the base, upside down holding it. Now next, with a start value of 9.50, will be the ETBU Tigers. A great performance by the Tigers. And as you can see, there's very different ways you can do these pyramids. Right there, you saw the ETBU Tigers take a different approach with two bases instead of one base in a bridge. Now, with those two bases, they did take the point deduction of their start value, but I still believe it was a very successful pyramid right there.
I would completely agree. It was strong top position, good work by the middle there, kind of keeping everything together, the balance and the strength it takes at the same time to be that middle is something that is often underappreciated by those who, you know, don't really know the sport super deeply.
Yeah, these are some intense athletes. They are constantly practicing and constantly working out with our personal trainer, Coach Paps. And I believe they are taken for granted, for sure.
I mean, I know I couldn't do any of this.
So no,
this
is, me neither.
This is one of the most impressive sports to watch.
You just have to think about the core strength, the arms, just everything. Crazy strength right there. But gymnasts, when you think about it, they train their whole lives to be flipped in the air like this. Isn't that crazy?
Like we mentioned earlier, many of these athletes coming from cheerleading and or gymnastics and or dance backgrounds.
If not all three. I believe there is some with all three. Okay, we'll now be going into Pyramid Heat 2, the synchronized pyramid. Up first with a start value of 9.90 is East Stroudsburg University.
East Stroudsburg, as we saw in the acro, tends to excel in the synchronized events. So we will see how well they continue to do in this.
Another clean performance by the Warriors. However, I did see some stability in synchronized issues right there.
It didn't seem like, especially with those middles that we were just talking about with ETBU, there was a little bit of a stability issue. It seems like they weren't quite able to lock their elbows as quickly as they would have liked to be able to. I mean, the whole thing about it is you're trying to hold them up as much as you can with bone structure rather than having to use your muscles.
Yes.
And so getting that lock quickly is so important.
Yeah, and it just did not look like the Warriors could get that lock very quickly. However, they did recover well. They did end very well. But number four, just continue. Their flyer just continues to impress and just stay consistent throughout the meet. Now, next up for the synchronized pyramid will be the ETBU Tigers with a start value of 9.50. Now, with this pyramid event, you are definitely seeing the scores of the ETBU Tigers going up and trying higher difficulty. A good performance by the Tigers. This event is focused all about being synchronized. However, at the end, you definitely saw the Tigers struggle with being synchronized. However, they were very well in the beginning.
Like you said, they were very well in the beginning. It did seem to start to fall apart a little bit, so we will see a deduction for that, obviously, especially in Heat 2. In these synchronized heats, so much is given to the synchronization, whereas, for example, in tumbling passes where you do need to be synchronized, but there are more things that they're looking for that are weighted more heavily. but in a named synchronized event, obviously it is going to be weighted a little more heavily. So we will see how much of a deduction ETBU is going to end up getting from that.
Yes, and I'm hoping it's not too much of a deduction, but I'm sure they'll make it up with this next pyramid. This is their strongest pyramid. Both teams are going for the 10.00 start value. I'm really excited to see what the ETBU Tigers have here and the Warriors as well. It's going to be a fun one to watch. Now, here up with a start value of 10.00 is East Stroudsburg University.
The Open Pyramid, one of those events that, or one of those heats, excuse me, that teams look to as a big points getter, no matter what team it is. And a big fall there.
Looks like it was the base right there. And that'll be a big deduction for the Warriors right there. Now, hopefully, the Tigers can make up for that right here and make a huge comeback.
Especially with that start value of 10, the big fall is going to be a big deduction.
Now, if you're curious about what an open pyramid can look like, any pyramid may be competed as long as it is different than the two previous heats before.
As we were waiting for the judges to score this one, like we were saying, it is going to be a sizable deduction, so we are going to have to wait on that before ETBU takes the mat for the open pyramid. It seems to be that judges do tend to take longer and longer in scoring when there is some major issue like that. They have to decide exactly how much that deduction is going to be.
Yes, and that'll be a huge one since they did not even finish the pyramid, I believe.
Obviously, ETBU looking to try to make up some ground.
Yes, that fall was huge for the Tigers. Very helpful for the Tigers if they can make this next pyramid their best pyramid. And like we said before, this will be the last event of this first half.
Now, after the first two events, the compulsory and the acro, like we mentioned, East Stroudsburg with a lead of, I'm trying to make sure I'm doing my math right, almost 9 points, let's say that.
Almost, yes.
Not great at math. So with this, ETBU could really get back into things in the pyramid, especially when we have things like the tumbling pass and the team event coming up at the end, which are those big point events. It's kind of the strategy from ETBU a lot of times can be, let's keep it close early and then really put the pedal to the metal at the end in the events that we're strong in.
Yes, after watching the last two acro meets, you can definitely tell they put all their effort in. Not saying that they do not put effort into the beginning, but all of their effort into those last few events to get the most points possible at the end, trying to make up for as much as they can. I believe that is their stronger events as well at the end, as you could see with the start value going up and up as we continue on.
ETBU also with a 10.00 start value, looking to go big here in the Open Pyramid.
Already starting off strong with a bridge in the bottom of the pyramid.
And ETBU obviously thrilled with their Open Pyramid. You can see the hugs, the high fives. And having a performance like that, especially after the big mistake by East Stroudsburg, is going to be a way that ETBU can make up a whole lot of points.
That was a huge pyramid for the Tigers right there. Every athlete working right there. I have to always shout out the base who is holding the bridge at the end is Katie Melton right there and Emma Levy. With the amazing flying at the to make this pyramid possible. And then you always call out the middles. I believe it was Ellie Davis this time.
Mm-hmm. Waiting on judges' final scores here before we go to halftime. And with that, we have scores in our final scores before halftime. Let's take a look at them real quick after I get them all in to my sheet here. So taking a look at the pyramid heat, or the pyramid event, excuse me. First off, for East Stroudsburg, they in the inversion with a start value of 9.80. Ending up with an 8.50. ETBU with a start value of 9.50, ending up with an 8.250. In the synchronized pyramid, East Stroudsburg with a 9.90 start value, ending up with an 8.550. ETBU with a 9.50 start value gets an 8.650. In Heat 3, the open heat, East Stroudsburg with a start value of 10.00, with that big fall, is scored an 5.800. ETBU with also with a start value of 10 and scoring an 8.750. Total score for the event for East Stroudsburg, 22.850. ETBU ending up with a 25.650. Your score at the half, East Stroudsburg Warriors with a 116.950. ETBU catching up in the pyramid heat with a 110.350. With that, we're going to take a break, let these athletes get a little bit of rest before we go into the second half.
All right.
And we're back here on ETBU Plus second half as we begin with the toss, starting out with the Warriors with the 450 Salto.
Yes, up first with that start, they had a start value of 8.80. And then next up with the exact same start value of 8.80 is the ETBU Tigers. Now let's introduce the event of itself. In this event, you will see four athletes toss a teammate into the air. The teammate tossed in the air, known as a top, will execute a flip or twist caught before being caught. There are three heats in this event: 450 Salto heat, the synchronized heat, and an open heat. The synchronized toss features two toss groups. These groups should look exactly alike and be in sync. The start value of the toss depends on the skill that the top executes in the air. Officials will be looking for extension by the top, the height of the top when executing her skill, the top's body position, and tight catches by the bases. This event is very much centered around the flyer and the top itself. Now the event we're in is the 450 Salto toss, and they're required to have a minimum of 450 degree rotation in the air.
A very difficult heat. It's known specifically for its difficulty. And good execution there by East Stroudsburg ETBU, like you said, coming in with the same start value
of 8.80.
And great execution there from ETBU. Obviously, very happy with their performance.
Yes, that was Jaden Stroman as their flyer right there. Looked very good and clean. Now, next up will be the synchronized heat. Now, like I've said with every event so far, let's list over the requirements of this element. There's a maximum of four athletes that may toss a single flyer, so there's no other athletes on the mat. Athletes may cross over and compete in two heats, one of which must be a synchronized toss, which we're about to see. Synchronized toss must have two groups perform the same toss, an open, identical, and synchronized skill right here. Now, walking in with a 9.25 start value is East Stroudsburg University. Now with that synchronized toss, you could tell they were a little unsynchronized in the air. However, everything else looked great by the Warriors.
Yeah, everything else looking good. Like you said, a little bit of a synchronization issue, maybe a bit heavy on the catch over there on the right-hand side of your screen. So a couple small deductions, but it's not going to be anything major. 9.25 start value for them. A very strong synchronized toss from the Warriors.
Now, with the toss event, I would say the ETBU Tigers and the Warriors are very well matched in this event. Their start values are looking very similar, if not the same, for almost every single event.
Now, this is when we start to see ETBU really start to excel. Obviously, they made up some ground in the pyramid. The deficit between these two teams going from almost 9 to,
I believe, 6.
Down to 6.6 points separating these two teams. This is very tight as we are going through the toss and as we go into tumbling.
Next, with a star value of 9.25, is the ETBU Tigers.
And ETBU is thrilled with their performance there, and for good reason.
A great performance right there. Very synchronized and working well together as a team.
Yeah, working well together as a team. The one thing that you may see a bit of a deduction from is over on the left-hand side of your screen. You did see the catchers have to move a little bit to get the catch cleanly and safely. So that may be a little minor deduction, but we shouldn't see any major deductions from ETBU. Very strong overall.
Yes, for sure. Now we'll have one more heat in this open toss right here, and it'll be the open toss. And ETBU Tigers is looking to make up for some points right here with a higher start value than the Warriors, which I believe is the first in this whole meet.
You are correct. This is the first time so far that ETBU will have a higher start value than East Stroudsburg. East Stroudsburg with a 9.00 start value. ETBU coming in with a 9.25. So a chance to make up some more ground here.
Now, to open up a little bit more about the open toss right here, one group will perform this toss, and it will be an open skill, which means whatever they are best at and feel they need to perform.
Thank you. East Stroudsburg now coming in with the open toss. Like we said, start value of 9.00. Looking very strong.
A clean performance there by the Warriors. But next up with a higher start value for the first time of this meet is the ETBU Tigers with a 9.25 start value. They're definitely looking to make up some points right here and get back into the lead. Now Jess Coleman with a full twist right there. Very strong performance. It looked very good, and I'm excited to see what that score will be. Hopefully bring the Tigers back up.
Now from the scores that we've gotten so far, no spoilers, but from the scores we've gotten so far, these two teams staying very, very tight in this toss event.
Like I said, this is a very evenly well-matched teams right here. And especially for this event, their event's start values were so similar, if not the same, throughout the entire event.
So we wait on those scores in the open toss for both teams.
And that'll be the end of the fourth event right here.
So a bit of a score correction here. It looks like there was some misdone math. After the first half, the scores were actually 89.900 for the East Stroudsburg Warriors and 83.050 for ETBU.
Which is still having the Tigers down by 6 points.
Yeah, Yeah, like you said, ETBU still down by 6.850 points after the first half. So with those corrections, ETBU making up 2.7 points just on heat three of the pyramid and making it, like we said, so that ETBU is down by just over a little over 6 points before the toss. Now let's get into the scores for the toss event. First off, for the 450 Salto heat one, East Stroudsburg with a start value of 8.80, coming in with an 8.550. ETBU, same start value of 8.80, coming in with an 8.500. In heat two, the synchronized toss, East Stroudsburg coming in with a 9.25 start value, same as ETBU. East Stroudsburg scoring an 8.600 to ETBU's 8.350. In heat three, the open toss, East Stroudsburg coming in with a 9.00 and scoring an 8.200. ETBU with a start value of 9.25, coming in with an 8.800. Total scores for the toss event, East Stroudsburg with a 25.350, ETBU with a 25.650, making the running score, East Stroudsburg 115.250, ETBU 108.700. So a little more ground made up for ETBU. Nothing crazy, but scores staying similarly tight after the toss as we go into the tumbling events, which tend to be fan favorites at these acrobatics and tumbling meets.
Now, right now, you're seeing the first event right here is a duo pass with a start value for East Stroudsburg University of 8.75. We have athletes Chloe and Carly competing in that one.
Obviously, the duo pass, they are looking for a lot of synchronization, as is also seen in the triple and the quad pass. There was a bit of a synchronization issue in the beginning, but it seemed to clean up that final landing very synchronized, so they will not see quite as much of a deduction as they maybe could have on synchronization.
Yes, let's get a little bit more into the tumbling event itself. This event has six heats. The first three are synchronized group tumbling passes, a duo, trio, and quad tumbling passes. The last three are individual tumbling passes. The start value, like before, of each heat is determined by the difficulty and combination of skills in each pass. Officials will be looking for synchronization in the first three heats, as well as continuing skills in the acceleration of the pass, proper body positions, during skills, and the body positions and control of the landing for each athlete. Now for the duo tumbling pass, they're looking for two athletes to execute synchronized identical tumbling passes. Next up with a start value of 8.55 from ETBU Tigers is number 5 Jessica Coleman and number 19 Macy Goff competing right here in this pass. Great performance by the Tigers. You could tell the synchronization was a little off between the both of them. Both completed both skills without any falls.
It seemed like they kind of had the opposite issue of the Warriors. The synchronization good in the beginning, fell apart a little bit at the end. That seems to be the more common issue that we see teams face.
Yes, for sure. And next we'll be heading into the trio pass, which will be three athletes must execute a synchronized identical tumbling pass. And like, I don't believe we said it before, each event will be worth 10 points each, and there'll be six heats throughout this event.
So another thing about these tumbling events, the athletes may compete in both the synchronized portion and in one single pass, but they are only allowed to tumble a maximum of two times. So another strategy part of this sport, trying to figure out which athletes you want in which parts. Usually you see your aerial, your six element, and your open single to be your best three tumblers.
Yes, I do believe one of our strongest tumblers that you just saw right there is Macy Goff. She's going to be in most events throughout the tumbling portion. Now we move on to the trio pass. Up first with a start value of 8.50 is East Stroudsburg University. We'll see number 23, number 37, and number 42 for the Warriors. Great control and landing by the Warriors right there. That was a great job. And as you can see, their team is very excited about their performance right there.
Yeah, it was great work there on that trio pass. The synchronization was good. The landings were great. The body position in the air was great. So a lot to be happy with for the Warriors there. This is one where these two teams will once again have the same start value of 8.50.
Yes, another event that this team is just so evenly matched with the Warriors and the Tigers. Next up with a start value of, again, like we said before, 8.50 is the East Texas Baptist University Tigers. And competing in this pass will be number one, Maddie Alonzo, number five, Jessica Coleman, and number 19, Macy Goff. A great performance by the Tigers right there. Very synchronized, looked well.
Yeah, like you said, very synchronized. Good work by the Tigers there. In some of these passes, you kind of see the mantra to keep it simple, right?
Yes.
Sometimes the simple is better. ETBU executing very well on the more simple pass there.
Yes, tumbling, like we said, acrobatics is a mixture of gymnastics, cheer, and dance. And right here, you're getting to show off all your gymnastic skills. And you'll see these scores be a little bit lower of a start value, but that is just simply because of these skills are so difficult to do on the floor. The final heat of the synchronized passes will be the quad pass, and up first with a start value of 7.5 is East Stroudsburg University. Competing in this pass will be number 5, number 7, number 15, and number 36. A great performance by the Warriors. I know they're going to be happy with that performance. They were synchronized and a great execution of that pass. And their teammates have no problem celebrating that great performance.
Yeah, it was great work there. Like you said, great synchronization. They were able to keep that line well. One of the things the judges look for, the athletes may start out at whatever point they want, but their goal is to try to end up in as much of a straight line as possible, or one of the goals, I guess I should say. Good landings, good synchronization.
Yes, that team definitely ended up all in the same line. It was a great execution there by the Warriors. Next up with a start value of 7.00 is East Texas Baptist University Tigers, number 2, Zoe Connor, number 4, Emma Levy, number 10, Ellie Davis, and number 14, Jaden Stroman will be competing in this pass. Great work by the Tigers. However, they did not end up in a straight line just as the Warriors did. That will be a point deduction, even though they were with a lower start value.
Like you said, that will be a deduction. There were not quite stumbles, but a couple little extra steps on some of the landings there. So that will be another little deduction.
And that will be it for all of the
synchronized tumbling
passes. Thank you. And now we'll head into individual tumbling passes, where there will be only one athlete on the mat at one time. We will now head into individual tumbling passes. First up will be the aerial pass. And with starting off with the aerial pass with a start value of 8.75 is East Stroudsburg University. Competing for this pass is number 37. Great work by the Warrior, number 37.
Alexandria Timperio doing a good job there.
Now with an aerial, they're looking for a single pass that they must execute one flip before the final flip in pass. Now, like I said before, ETBU has a very strong tumbler in Macy Goff, and she will be competing in this next aerial pass, and she's only allowed, like we said before, one singular individual pass. And she will be competing with a 9.45 start value for the ETBU Tigers.
Yeah, like you said, she is one of the strongest tumblers, if not the strongest tumbler that ETBU has, showing it off with that high start value.
Yes, that is the highest start value of the Tigers in this event. With this aerial pass is number 19, Macy Goff.
And aside from that little stumble there on the final landing, phenomenal work by Macy Goff.
Yes, like we said, she's one of their strongest tumblers, and her team is so excited about that performance right there. You could tell the difference in that difficulty right there, for sure, between the Warriors and the Tigers. Macy Goff was definitely not afraid to show off all of the skills that she has. The fifth heat in the tumbling event is the sixth element pass, and up first with a start value of 9.15 from East Stroudsburg University is number 18.
Carly Nehis starting her pass. And great work.
A great performance right there. Now, with this event, they are looking for six elements, including your last skill, in a single pass. Here we'll see a significant point difference between the teams right here. That was a very high start value for East Stroudsburg, and they showed why. Carly had a great performance right there. Next up with a start value of 7.45 for the East Texas Baptist University Tigers is number 1, Maddie Alonzo.
Maddie Lozano, number 1 for the Tigers, with a good pass.
Great performance there by Maddie.
And you see Katie Melton getting out there, fired up for her teammate.
Yes, that is definitely a team player right there. She is so excited for her team. We will now head into the final heat of tumbling, and that will be open pass. Now with open pass, there are no requirements at all. It is just one singular pass with one individual athlete. Up first with a start value of 8.5 from East Stroudsburg University is number 23, Julia Dessert.
And good work by her there.
Did take quite a fall at the end of her own celebration, but that's okay. At least it was not during her pass. Now with this event, I could tell both of these athletes are very well evenly matched. Both teams are coming in with a start value of 8.5, and competing for this next event in open pass for the ETBU Tigers is number 5, Jessica Coleman. She is another one of the great tumblers that this ETBU team has, and we're excited to see what she has in this open pass with no requirements, like I said before. Like I said before, this will be a start value of 8.50 for the East Texas Baptist University Tigers, and it will be number 5, Jessica Coleman. A good, clean performance with a full at the end from Jess Coleman.
Yeah, great work there by Coleman. Great body position, very clean landings for her.
Yes, it'll be very interesting to see what these scores come out to be, because they were so evenly matched but also so diverse throughout the start values of each pass. That'll be the end of event number 5, the tumbling event. We have one more event here at this meet, and that will be the team event, which is possible of 110 points, the biggest event of the entire meet.
Yeah, like you said, this team event, obviously everyone loves the tumbling passes, this team event, because it combines everything that we have seen so far. It combines those dance elements. It is obviously a crowd pleaser. It's something that everyone loves to see, and it can really, really swing the scores. These two teams still sitting very close. A good team event can make or break your entire meet.
Yes, and that's why it's right there smack at the end of the meet for you to try to put your all into the end. Now, when people ask me about acro, I always say it's a combination of dance, gymnastics, and cheer. And this next team event will show exactly what I mean by that. You'll be seeing all different skills and all different athletes in this next event.
Let's take a look at the scores in tumbling before we get to the team event. First off, for the duo pass, the Warriors with a start value of 8.75, coming in with an 8.050. ETBU with a start value of 8.55, coming in with a 7.850. In the triple pass, East Stroudsburg starting with an 8.50, ending up with a 7.950. ETBU starting with an 8.50, ending up with a 5 even. In the quad pass, start value for the Warriors is 7.50, getting a 6.850. ETBU starting with a start value of 7, coming in with a 6.40. In the aerial pass, East Stroudsburg starting with a 8.75, scoring an 8.500. ETBU starting with a 9.45 and getting a 9.25. In the sixth element, the Warriors starting with a 9.15, scoring an 8.900. ETBU with a start value of 7.45, scoring a 7.225. For the open pass, an 8.50 start value for the Warriors, scoring an 8.250. ETBU, same start value, scoring 8.40. The total for the tumbling for the Warriors, 48.500 for ETBU, 44.125. Your score before we go to the team event, 163.750 for the Warriors and 152.825 for the Tigers as the Warriors take the floor for the team event.
Now with a 9.982 start value, please welcome to the floor East Stroudsburg University.
We'll be right back.
good performance there by the Warriors. There definitely was some synchronized issues there, but throughout there was no falls, and it was a good performance overall by the Warriors.
It seemed like the major issues, the tumbling, extremely clean throughout. The dance portion at the end looked very good. It seemed like many of the synchronization issues seemed like it came when they were coming down from top position, especially in some of the acro stuff that you saw early in the team event. There were a couple little issues with some pyramids, maybe a couple of shaky catches in the toss, but overall a very strong team event performance for the Warriors. Obviously, they were happy with how they performed, and they ought to be. It was very good overall.
Now, I'm going to introduce the team event a little bit to you. The team event encompasses everything you just watched in these first five events. The team event features up to 24 athletes on the floor at one time performing skills in acro, toss, pyramid, and tumbling in a routine set to music. Each routine contains required skills and optional skills, and the start value is based on the difficulty of skills selected to fulfill requirements. Execution deductions are the same in this event as in the previous event. Larger deductions are applied if an athlete falls or does not complete a skill. This is a very fast-paced event, so be sure to keep your eyes on the mat. And with that being said, it's always so hard for me to figure out what to be watching on the mat whenever the team event is happening.
Yeah, there's so much going on. Like you said, it's very fast-paced. It's electric, honestly. The very upbeat music that these teams use obviously aids in that. And so it's a fun event to watch overall.
Yes, and that's what I was saying earlier. It brings out that dance and cheer background of some of the athletes. So it's very exciting to watch. Now, each of these skills, choreographed skills, must be performed with a maximum of 2 minutes and 30 seconds using a minimum of at least 18 athletes and a maximum of 24 athletes. There is a 30 acro element, 5 tosses, 4 pyramids, 1 jump slash standing tumbling pass per number of athletes on the mat, 1 running tumbling pass per number of athletes on the mat. Additional scored categories are a routine, construction, dance, composition, and artistry, and that 50% of the team must perform 2 to 8 counts throughout the pass.
This is another event that really shows how tough it is to coach this sport. Obviously, the choreography that goes into it, especially for the team event, is so crucial.
Yes, and I believe the ETBU Tigers will be using all athletes on the mat for this team event. And like I said before, the ETBU Tigers are competing without their senior leader, Brianna Brown, but they're hoping to make it for her to make a comeback throughout the season. She is a strong athlete as well, and I know they are missing her throughout these events. And with a start value of 95.99, the ETBU Tigers are now taking the mat. Shh. Great job by the ETBU Tigers. They did have a couple of falls and a couple mistakes throughout, but they're hoping to make up for that with the high difficulty start value.
Yeah, there was some synchronization issues at the beginning. Obviously not the cleanest of landings on all of those tumbling passes. There was a pyramid there in the middle where we did see them have to bail out early. They didn't quite have the strength that they needed, and so it wasn't the cleanest team event that we've seen from ETBU. ETBU, usually a team that does well in the team event, so obviously they're going to be a little disappointed with their performance on this one, but still good overall.
Yes, there will be some major deduction points for not completing one of the pyramids and a couple falls throughout the tumbling passes. So we are hoping for the best right here for the scores.
As we come in, as we get final scores, first for the team event, final score for the team event for East Stroudsburg, 89.170. ETBU coming in with a 74.740. Final scores here in today's meet for the visiting East Stroudsburg University Warriors, 252.920, and for your ETBU Tigers, 227.565. The Warriors taking the victory in this one, but a lot of positives for ETBU. Their best score of the year so far by just under 8 points. So didn't quite get the score in the team event that they wanted, but a lot of positives to take from this meet.
Yes, they're definitely growing and just improving. As you can see, this was their best score, and it's only the third meet of the season. They have so much more season left to go and just improve.
Well, as these two teams gather in the middle of the mat to pray, thank you so much for joining us.